Most of you probably already know what virtual reality is. It's great fun, it's very immersive, it allows people to connect remotely, to explore faraway places, or to face your fears. Now, you may think that VR is just for entertainment, that it's just a gimmick or a futuristic fad, but it's really a great way to share stories. When you experience a story in VR, we feel like we are right there in the moment, experiencing everything firsthand. And storytellers use this emotional connection that they have with you through this story to capture your attention and move you. And they often rely on intense emotional experiences, and that's why virtual reality is the perfect medium to deliver them. Some experiences might even be transformative, eye-opening, or perspective-changing. But there is a problem. When we design intense emotional experiences in an already powerful medium, which is virtual reality, we create the capacity for overwhelming and supercharged experiences, stuff that's just too much for some people to handle and to take in. And this is because at the moment, we just don't know enough about how people appraise, construct, and regulate intense emotions designed in this medium. And this is where the science comes in. Science, and especially psychology, can help us understand how to design VR experiences that are impactful and transformative. By integrating scientific evidence into the design process, we can ensure that VR experiences are not only emotionally powerful, but also safe and responsible. Psychology also helps us dovetail design decisions into a clear goal, which can range from distraction to entertainment or empowerment. One emotional experience that is key to modern audiovisual entertainment is awe. Awe is very hard to define, to prompt, or to capture, and you might have lived awe-filled moments in very different situations in your lives because of how personal it is as an experience. And it is typically defined as a feeling of reverential respect mixed with fear or wonder. It sits as this very intersection and has this dual emotional valence. You might mostly feel awe in nature with very wide and vast sceneries, with this sense of vastness that's key to this emotional experience. But you might also find awe in more interpersonal, intimate settings where so many stories will move and inspire you. And so this shows that awe can elicit shifts of perspective, which is a key cognitive process in many aspects of our lives. And this shift of perspective can in turn reshape our narrative identity. And this narrative identity is the story that we create about ourselves to make sense of the different situations we go through. And so this is where everything comes together. My research explores how awe can be designed into VR. And I am working with the Children's Hospital to see how we can implement VR in the hospital, but also explore how this transformative experience can help children alleviate their anxiety. So children in hospitals face challenges on a daily basis. And one of the most challenging parts is the surgical process. And despite being surrounded by teams of specialists, with the surgeons, the play specialists, and the nurses to help them make sense of the intervention and what they are going to go through, some of them might still feel anxious. And so depending on what they are in for, they must be sedated, which in turn has a negative ripple effect to the parents, to the staff, and in the grander scheme of things, to the hospital itself as well. And this anxiety can stem from an insufficient understanding of the situation, also from the absence of agency and decision-making over what is happening to them, because typically children are just here to for the intervention, but they don't have the option to say no, they just have to well, taking everything that's given or done to them. And it also can come from a negative perception of the hospital after many interventions. And I believe that VR can be driven by science to our children in a way that address these issues and to positively shift the children's personal narratives in a way to prompt behavior changes. So currently, my VR project is in its very early stages, but we are collecting data from the voices of the children to incorporate their fears, concerns, and what they would like to see in the experience into the design process. And by incorporating their voices directly, we can create experiences that are impactful, transformative, but also fun, which is a key element for them to engage with the content. And so psychology can help us make sure that the technology and experiences are accepted, that children will in fact engage with them, and that we also have effective, measurable behavior changes, which is key to reiterate this experience in the future and to know how effective it is. And in the meantime, we are exploring a few ideas. So how awesome would it be for children to explore the surgery theater, only to see the walls disappear and reveal the secret room of a wizard?
The old one spoke of strings that tie reality together. Bring things under your control by pulling on their tether.
So this is just an example of a fun experience from which we are drawing inspiration. And children can come with so much interesting stuff to make in terms of experiences. One of them has been mentioning as a way to relax and improve the breathing exercises, maybe having the frost breath of Superman in the experience. And that's something that can definitely be done very easily. So by having their viewpoints, is key to just design this kind of experience. And they will only have the desired effects if they are designed in this way, informed by the scientific evidence, the voice of the target audience, and if they enable the process that we want to facilitate, which is this decision-making, empowerment, agency, and so on. So VR has the power to awe and transform, and science helps us harness that power for the benefit of people. Thank you.